There are loads of bacteria on your teeth, skin, nails, etc. They're everywhere. As we speak, trillions of bacteria are enjoying the party in your body, and you don't even know it. But there's good bacteria and bad bacteria. The good bacteria are prebiotics and probiotics. They help your gut. In today's video, let's run through the benefits of prebiotics and probiotics, along with foods that are loaded with them. Why is having yogurt important? What do you think of tomatoes? We're talking about all this and more. So, what are probiotics and prebiotics? If you're someone who takes your health seriously, you've probably heard these two terms. They sound the same, but have different roles. Our digestive tract contains many species of bacteria, also known as gut flora. This consists of both good and bad bacteria. Probiotics consist of live bacteria and yeasts that are present in certain foods or health supplements. They have many health benefits like fighting the bad bacteria in our digestive system. Prebiotics consist of certain types of fibers, which are not digested by your gut. The good bacteria in the gut feed on these fibers and remain healthy, maintaining your gut health. In short, prebiotics are good bacteria, while probiotics are like delicious meals for these bacteria. Both prebiotics and probiotics keep our system happy and healthy. Have you ever tried any supplements to get prebiotics and probiotics? Sound off in the comments below and stay connected with our ever-growing Bestie community. Why should you care about your gut bacteria? The good bacteria in the digestive tract have a protective role for your gut. They compete with potentially harmful bacteria and fungi for resources and destroy them. A study by a group of gut doctors confirmed that the good bacteria in the gut performed a wide variety of functions, from improving your immune health to preventing diarrhea. The gut bacteria may even improve your mental health and decrease the risk of obesity. The healthy gut bacteria also produce vitamin K and fatty acids. Short-chain fatty acids feed the cellular lining of the large intestine, particularly your colon. They act as a strong shield against chemicals, bad bacteria, and viruses. This has anti-inflammatory properties and can reduce your risk of cancer. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all our great Bestie content. What you eat affects your gut flora. Every small thing you consume has an effect on your gut health. The food we eat plays a vital role in balancing out the good and bad bacteria. It's a known fact that a diet with high sugar and fat contribute to things like insulin resistance. This messes with your gut bacteria, leading to diabetes and obesity. A high sugar and protein diet feeds bad bacteria more than the good kind. Once this happens, the bad bacteria are given a boost and start multiplying at a much quicker rate. The good bacteria are outnumbered by the bad. This makes the good kind much weaker. The body mass index, BMI, is the best predictor of obesity worldwide. Studies have shown that bad gut bacteria have been linked to higher BMI. A higher BMI not only leads to obesity and diabetes, but also hypertension and reduced life expectancy. In addition to this, our gut flora is badly affected by the pesticides in today's food products. These pesticides have a deteriorating effect on gut flora, causing adverse health effects. Studies have also shown that antibiotics can cause permanent changes in certain types of bacteria, especially when taken during childhood and adolescence. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might want to take a look at. Watch 11 silent stress signs that are killing you slowly. So, which foods are good for probiotics? Number 1, yogurt. Yogurt is hands down the easiest and tastiest source of good bacteria. Begin your day with a power-packed cup of Greek yogurt. You can make frozen berry, banana, and yogurt cups just by mixing them with a few nuts of your choosing. Cinnamon and honey are also good for sweetening. Make sure you're using Greek yogurt. Pour the mix into small molds and place them in the freezer. Soon enough, your cup will be ready to enjoy. Number 2, kefir. Kefir is the distant cousin of yogurt. It's usually made from the milk of goats, sheep, and cows. People call kefir the champagne of milk due to its smooth, creamy, and bubbly texture. Kefir has so many health benefits. One of the better effects is great bones. It's very easy to make homemade kefir with kefir grains. Just add these grains to the milk and let the magic happen. After a few hours, your fermented probiotic drink is ready. Number 3, sauerkraut. Cabbage becomes healthier as it ages. Sauerkraut is literally a no-brainer for probiotics. It's made easily. Something as simple as plain salt can be used to make fancy spice sauerkraut. After fermenting it for 2 to 3 weeks, it's ready to go with your broths, mustards, and Reuben sandwiches. Not only can it help your gut, sauerkraut can also improve the health of your eyes. Number 4, miso. This is a fermented paste made with soybeans, grains, salt, water, and koji. If you want to go soybean-free, chickpeas will do the trick. All these ingredients are mashed and bottled up for a few months to a few years. After that, it goes great with soups, salad dressings, dips, and pretty much any other thing you want. Miso is loaded with probiotics and can enhance your immune and digestive system like never before. It also keeps cancer away. Number 5, tempeh. This is often confused with tofu, a distant cousin of tempeh. Fermented soybeans are pressed down into a patty. The soybeans need to be slightly processed. It's more flavorful than the traditional tofu, which is made from coagulated soy milk. Tempeh is a great source of plant-based protein. It offers a crunchy, dense texture, whereas tofu is soft and spongy. Use it as a taco filling in veggie burgers, stir fries, salads, and sandwiches. Tempeh can be sliced up and tossed in a pan with a few sauces to give you a healthy meal filled with vitamins. It's low fat and zero cholesterol. You can easily find it in the frozen food section at your grocery store. Number 6, kimchi. This is a traditional Korean dish with fermented vegetables. Most kimchi has cabbage, onion, radish, carrot, and other vegetables, along with spices of your choice. All these ingredients are great for your digestion. Kimchi can be eaten by itself or added to noodles for a great taste. The spicy flavor adds a kick to your food. Once you're done, you'll only want to try more of it. It'll help improve your immune system. If you're new to probiotics, go easy. Too many can cause stomach aches, diarrhea, bloating, and gas. Give your body time to adjust. Now, which foods are good for prebiotics? Number 1, onions. Onions can be found on every menu and in so many different foods. You may have to pop in a breath mint after having them, but they're worth it. They have so many nutrients. Onions improve digestion by feeding your gut bacteria. They have antioxidants as well as good bacteria called inulin to fight indigestion. You can caramelize onions in the oven or stir-fry them for curries, pasta, and noodles. They also go well on top of your hot dog. These are all the easiest ways to get prebiotics in your diet. Number 2, garlic. Garlic is an herb with anti-inflammatory effects. You can use crushed garlic in most of your recipes. Maybe roast them and put them in your hummus. Also, you can use garlic butter as a spread for your pita chips. Whichever style you choose, garlic helps fight bad bacteria. It's also an anti-cancer food. Don't forget to add them to your soups, sauces, and avocado toast. The first bite guarantees satisfaction. Number 3, tomatoes. Tomato sauce has lycopene, which keeps your heart healthy and helps you stay away from cancer. It gives tomatoes their bright red color and is a great source of vitamin C, potassium, folate, and vitamin K. Tomatoes can be used in salads, fresh salsas, soups, relish, curries, and gravies. Number 4, artichokes. You may have stayed away from this veggie as a kid, but there are so many reasons to like it as an adult. Go for the frozen or canned artichokes. They're good for quick consumption. Make sure they're sugar-free though. I personally love eating them with garlic and olive oil. It tastes delicious after coating it with tapioca flour. Raw baby artichokes can be sliced and tossed with lemon dressing in your salads. They help to reduce blood sugar levels and increase good cholesterol. They also help to ease out the symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome. Number 5, oats. Oatmeal is a great way to start your day. It holds truckloads of fiber. Oatmeal contains beta-glucan, which relieves you from bloating and gas. Oatmeal can reduce your chances of colon cancer and manage your weight. It can give you a blast of antioxidants and manage your sugar levels as well. Number 6, beans and peas. Chickpeas, green peas, and all types of beans are rich sources of prebiotics. Try eating a bowl full of legumes at least once a day. They have balanced fiber and natural sugars, which boost your gut bacteria. You can even make an excellent soup out of lima beans, black-eyed beans, kidney beans, and pinto beans. Number 7, nuts. Nuts are prebiotic-friendly and can be a quick snack for those who are always on the go. Cashews, almonds, pistachios, chestnuts, and hazelnuts are a few of the top choices. These will fill you with energy and satisfy your gut. Do you like pecans and hazelnuts? What about exotic Brazil nuts? Watch our video on 6 nuts you should be eating and 6 you shouldn't. If cashews are your favorite, don't miss out on what happens to your body when you eat cashews every day. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about how to become healthier. Which are your favorite pre and probiotic foods? Let us know in the comments below.